Hello friends, welcome back. In this tutorial, we will study about representation of relations. In this tutorial, we will study how we can represent relations. So first of all, we will study how we can represent a relation as a matrix. Suppose there is a relation R from set A to set B. Then what we will do, we will make a matrix. And rows of this matrix will be labeled by the elements of set A, and columns of this matrix will be labeled by the elements of set B. And whenever element A is related with element B through relation R, and this element A belongs to, definitely it will belongs to set A, and this element B will belong to set B, right? And these both elements A and B, right? As you can see here through this expression, element A is related to element B through relation R. Then what we will do, in a row which is labeled by element A and the column which is labeled by element B, right? In that place, we will write the entry 1. And wherever element A is not related to element B, in that case, what we will do, in Ath row and Bth column, in Ath row and Bth column, we will write 0, right? It will be more clear after this example. Now suppose R is a relation from set A to set B. Right. Now set A has these elements 1, 2, 3 and 4. And set B has these elements A, B, C and D. Now the relation R has these ordered pairs 1A, 1B, 1C, 2B, 2C and 2D. Now this is the relation R. Now how we can represent this relation R by a matrix? So we will make a matrix. Now this is the relation R from set A to set B. So rows of this matrix will be labeled by the elements of set A, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. And columns will be labeled by the elements of set B, A, B, C and D. Now see, in relation R you can see that 1 is related to A through relation R. There is an ordered pair 1A. So in row labeled by 1 and column labeled by A, in that place we will write 1, right? Similarly, you can see 1B. So in 1th row and Bth column, we will mark 1. Similarly, in for 1C, we will mark here 1, right? Now see 2B. So in 2th row and Bth column, we will mark 1. For 2C, in 2th row and Cth column, we will mark 1. And for 2D, in 2th row and Dth column, we will mark 1, right? And rest of the entries will be 0. So in this way, we can represent a relation by a matrix. Now let us see another way. We can represent a relation by a directed graph also, right? So let us see how we can represent a relation by a directed graph. Now see, in this case what happens, the relation R must be from a finite set to itself, right? When the relation is from a finite set to itself, only then we can represent the relation by directed graph, right? Now suppose there is a set A and it has these elements 1, 2, 3, 4. Now there is a relation R from set A to set A itself. Now suppose this relation R has these ordered pairs 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 4, right, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 1 and 4, 3. So what we need to do, first we will see how many elements are there in set A. In set A there are four elements, so we will make four nodes in a directed graph, right? So this node is for element 1, this node is for element 2, this node is for element 3, and this node is for element 4. Now what we need to do, if an element A is related to element B through relation R, then what we will do, from node A to node B, we will draw a directed edge. So as you can see here, in relation R there is an ordered pair 1, 2, so it means 1 is related to 2 through relation R. So from 1 to 2 we will draw an edge. Now see, 2 is related to 2, so here we will draw a self loop. 2 is related to 4, so from 2 to 4 we will draw this edge. Now see this ordered pair 3, 2, since 3 is related to 2, so from 3 to 2 we will draw an directed edge, right? So similarly for 3, 4, there will be an edge from 3 to 4. Now see 4, 1, so there will be an edge from 4 to 1. 4, 3, so there will be an edge from 4 to 3. So this directed graph represents this relation R. Now there is another way also to represent a relation. We can represent a relation as an arrow diagram also. Now see, next way to represent a relation is as an arrow diagram. So in this case what we will do, suppose there is a relation R from set A to set B, then what we will do, we will draw two ellipses. In one ellipse we will write all the elements of set A, and in another ellipse we will write all the elements of set B, right? So if there is an element X of set A, and suppose there is an element Y of set B, and X is related to Y through relation R, then we will draw an arrow from X to Y, right? So it will be more clear after this example. Suppose there are two sets P and Q. Suppose we have two sets P and Q. Set P has these elements 1, 2, 3 and 4. And set Q has these elements A, B, C and D. Now suppose there is a relation R from set P to set Q, and this relation R has these ordered pairs 1A, 2A, 3A, 1B, 4B, 4C, 4D. Right. Now to represent this relation R by an arrow diagram, first we will draw these two ellipses. This is for set P and this is for set Q. So set P has these elements 1, 2, 3 and 4, and set Q has elements A, B, C and D. Now see, in this relation R you can see that 1 is related to A, right? So we will draw an edge or an arrow from 1 to A. 2 is also related to A, so we will draw an arrow from 2 to A. 3 is also related to A, so we will draw an arrow from 3 to A. Now see, 1 is related to B, so we will draw an arrow from 1 to B. 4 is related to B, so we will draw an arrow from 4 to B. 4 is related to C, so we will draw an arrow from 4 to C, and similarly for 4D we will draw this arrow from 4 to D. Now there is another way to represent a relation. We can represent a relation as a table also. we can represent a relation as a table. Now, how we can represent a relation as a table? Suppose there is a relation R from set P to set Q. Then what we will need to do is we need to make a table, right? We will make a table, and what happens, rows of this table will be labeled by the elements of set P, right? And columns of this table will be labeled by the elements of set Q. Now, wherever element A is related to element B through relation R, in that case, what we will do in the table labeled by row A and the column labeled by B, right? In that entry in the table, we will mark like this, right? So wherever there is a relation between A and B, for that ordered pair AB, what we need to do for that ordered pair AB in this table, in Ath row and Bth column, in a row which is labeled by A and column which is labeled by B, in that entry, at that entry, we will mark this sign, right? So it will be more clear after this example. Again, see, suppose there is a set P and it has these elements 1, 2, 3 and 4, and set Q has these elements X, Y, Z and K. Now, suppose there is a relation R from set P to set Q, and it has these ordered pairs 1x, 1y, 2z, 3z, and 4k. So, to represent this relation by a table, first we will make a table. Rows will be labeled by the elements of set P, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. And columns will be labeled by the elements of set Q, X, Y, Z and K. So for ordered pair 1X, so in row labeled by 1 and column labeled by X, we will mark this sign. So for 1Y, in row labeled by 1 and column labeled by Y, we will mark this sign. For 2z, for ordered pair 2z, in this row labeled by 2 and column labeled by z, at that entry we will mark this sign. Similarly for 3z, here in this row and this column, at this entry we will mark this. For 4k, in row labeled by 4 and column labeled by k, we will mark this sign. So these are the ways to represent a relation.